Hi, welcome to this week's special episode of the Shtick. It's the beginning of season 44, our first show for that, and also our 1111th segment on YouTube. And as our special guest, we have somebody who's really in no need of any introduction, especially to me, but to our viewers. We've had Laibl Wolf on before. I'd like to welcome Rabbi Laibl Wolf.
Thank you so much. Good to be with you again.
It's such a pleasure to have you on again. And you are the founder and dean of Spiritgrow.
Yes, Spiritgrow Joseph Chris Center.
Fantastic. And what's your mission?
To change the world, much for the better, nothing less than that. I know it sounds ambitious, but I am a very big believer that the pebble that's dropped into the pond creates waves to the most distant shores.
Ripples.
Ripples, ripple away.
And you have been involved with the Jewish religion now for, well, not all your life. You weren't religious in the beginning, were you?
I came from a very traditional family. Mm. My parents, Holocaust survivors. My father was a yeshiva bocher, a teenager when the war broke out.
So you lost the connection to the yeshiva in a sense.
In that sense, my father, when he came to Australia, and mother, for a while, were estranged from it, came back to it, and I was raised in a traditional home.
And you married a lady from Sydney.
A lady from Sydney who comes from an illustrious Vilna background. Her father, a great Talmud Chacham, and a thoroughly modern and wonderful woman of the day.
And your wife, Leah, she's very involved with the Spiritgrow growth.
Fully 50% partner with me.
And your other partner's your son, Menachem.
The driving force. Menachem, yeah. Is the...
He's the new generation.
Not only new generation, I think he brings a quality of charisma and freshness which is just apropos the times we live in.
And you've just recently brought out an insert that was in every Jewish news a couple of weeks ago, which is all about growth, because it's called Spirit Grow. That's where the origin of the name came from.
It's interesting that name Spiritgrow existed for many decades as my email address.
Oh, really?
And then when we formed the centre, we thought of no better name because it really implies exactly who we are. We're talking about the deeper dimensions of life and the individual and how we actually grow that tender plant into full maturity.
And you're looking to pass on your knowledge in the sense that you're helping people find wellness and health through their connection with you.
One of the things I noticed through my now almost 30 years of travels internationally for lectures and the like is that there are four specific areas of life that people today find great personal interest and gravitate towards. And they are spirituality with a small s, it means anything which deepens people's lives, meditation, mindfulness and the like. Then there is the area of health and wellness. And because of the changing panorama of how we understand ourselves and also, unfortunately, the toxicity of commercialization, that's a specific arena that people are questing. Then there's an area of personal management, time, how do I handle time, how do I handle people? And finally, there's the particular area of relationships. How can I deepen relationships interpersonally, with the world, with matter, with God, with everything.
And to give more meaning to life, really.
Absolutely. That's the bottom line.
That is the bottom line. And you've got a very big emphasis on youth, on spirit kids. You've got this new concept of spirit kids. You find all these amazing words to describe what you do.
Our philosophy is that the kids are being raised in this milieu of today. Even though they might not articulate meaningfulness and depth, you've got to plant that into their minds at a tender age so that somewhere along the line, when they really begin to contend with life's challenges, they recall there is a pathway and it connects to Judaism and it helps the personal self to evolve and develop. So we're starting early, absolutely early.
And then there's the Spirit Teens, where you've got Aharon Adlist, who's your wonderful young rabbi, who looks after the teens who are going to be growing up in your environment.
if there's one moment in a young person's life, I should say family's life, where they start to take it very seriously, momentarily, it's called bar and bat mitzvah.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it may have social overtones and it may have significant overtones. It doesn't matter. It's something where focus is given. We want to make those 6 months, which we take a kid on his or her course, ones where they'll recall later on with pleasure, with joy, not necessarily depth of academia, but a sense of, yes, Judaism can be fun as well as meaningful. So we teach them meditation. We teach them to be mindful. We teach them sexual ethics. We teach them peer group pressure, self-esteem. We take them through all the kinds of things which are challenging them today.
And there's also the training that you do. You have this course, like in this lift out, where we're flashing up bits of what's inside it, because we're not going to go through it here. But you've got a fantastic course that goes on. This is like February, March and April. And then you're going to bring out one for May, June, July?
Absolutely.
Yeah, every 3 months you're going to bring out a guide.
Every 3 months we reprogram.
So it's a semester base.
It's by semester base.
Yeah, yeah.
Like in our first week, which just finished, would you believe we had over 700 people who came through our doors in
and you had to turn people away, which you hate doing.
This was a very, very sad aspect for me and for the team, that we are so successful that we actually don't have the space for people who are wanting to be participant in our programs. And this week that took place. We're putting steps into play to prevent that by splitting courses into two and the like. But you know, for Jen Smorgan's meditation, we had 110 and 30 turned away. For my mindfulness course, we again had a maximum of 110 and 25 turned away. It's unfortunate, but that's why we're going to grow into new premises, hopefully.
You are. Yeah, well, we'll talk about that when we come back in the next segment. We're going now to Newt's News, and we'll be back with more of Rabbi Laibl Wolf in the next segment to further our discussion.